The former Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu and several leaders of his Telugu Desam Party have been put under house arrest to prevent them from participating in a massive protest against the government run by YS Jagan Mohan Reddy. Large gatherings are banned by the police in Palnadu region, seen to be the worst affected by the violence fueled by political rivalries. The TDP had planned a protest against the alleged intimidation by the ruling YSR Congress Party. Now, in turn, the ruling party has also planned a counter march in protest against alleged violence unleashed by the previous government led by Mr. Naidu. The YSR Congress has asked people in Atmakur district and Palnadu region, seen to be the worst affected by the violence, to come forward and share their complaints. So there you have TDP leaders, including the former Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu, being placed under house arrest. The TDP planning this massive protest today against the YSR Congress government. Mr. Naidu's party has alleged that 8 TDP workers have been killed and several face threats from Mr. Reddy's party that completed 100 days in power last week. Let's go across to Uma Sudhir now for more. And Uma, Chandrababu Naidu as well as his son and TDP leaders placed under house arrest to prevent them from participating in this massive rally. Also a competing protest by the ruling party as well. Tell us which areas have been affected and what is happening.
Gargi, quite dramatic developments, in fact, since last night when police started being deployed around the houses of all the important Telugu Desam leaders. This happened after Telugu Desam President Chandrababu Naidu called for Chalo Atmakur protest. This is, Atmakur is an area in the Palnadu region in the Guntur Prakasam area where, in fact, there has been a lot of what is called locally faction violence. This is almost revenge politics between the cadre of different political parties, and what we understand is that some groups of people, because of the violence and the threats that they feel from the ruling party CADA, had been living outside the village. And what Chandrababu Naidu had proposed is that he would go there and take them back to their village and have some kind of a confidence building measures so that those people can go back and return to their homes along with their families, which means even small children who had to stay away from the village. This call by Chandrababu Naidu for Chalo Atmakur was followed by YSR Congress leaders also saying that they are also going to have a Chalo Atmakur on the very same day, which is the 11th of September, and they said that they would bring in victims of alleged violence by the cadre of the Telugu Desam when Chandrababu Naidu was the chief minister. And this kind of a competitive politics led to tension in the area, after which the police imposed section 144, which is prohibitory orders in the Guntur region. Like I was saying, deployment of police all around the Vijayawada, Krishna and Guntur districts, especially around the houses of the top leaders, they were not allowed to step out of their homes. In fact, Chandrababu Naidu has been detained inside his house, though he has been saying that he will go ahead with the Chalo Atmakur call. His son Nara Lokesh tried to come out, but he was stopped by the police as well. Right now, they are in confabulations with other Telugu Desam leaders about how to go about this. Vijayawada MP Kesineni Nani, in fact, tried to walk across the Prakasam barrage and was very dramatically stopped on the bridge itself and detained once again. Bhooma Akhilapriya, who has been a former Minister of the Telugu Desam, she was in Novotel Hotel, and she was, in fact, she has been complaining that the police entered into the rooms of Telugu Desam leaders without any permission at all. So all Telugu Desam leaders saying that this is a dark day in democracy and that the YSR Congress does not want them to reach out to victims of local political violence. But some other political activists, in a sense, pointing out that both these parties have been, in a sense, indulging in these kind of competitive politics between each other, and therefore the same message seems to go down the line, and that's the reason why even at the CADA level there is a lot of tension. So while section 144 is in place, Telugu Desam leaders, many of them, most of them should I say, in all these areas put under house arrest, but the Telugu Desam determined that they will go ahead with it, police being deployed in all these places.